the effort by the government to increase the borrowings on treasury bills by the government by another 1,000 billion rupees. Now, I would like to quote here, Madam Presiding Member, the government in its in the Minister of Finance's Fiscal Management Report 2020-2021 under the theme, the Fiscal Developments, Treasury Operations and Foreign Financing section, I quote, the government introduced a simple, transparent and efficient tax system in the latter part of 2019 and the beginning of 2020 to stimulate the economy by augmenting aggregated demand. The tax structure was simplified by removing economic tax service charge, national building tax and debt repayment levy. Personal and corporate income tax structures were revised. Value-added tax rate slashed to 8% from 15% and VAT registration threshold expanded. Now, this quote, Honourable Presiding Member, looked at in isolation, looks very elegant and inspiring. Holistically, every economic action has an economic cost. The question I like to pose to the government is this. Did the government evaluate the economic impact of this elegant and inspiring course of action to introduce a simplified, transparent and efficient tax system, which was later endorsed in November 2020? This too amid the worst economic calamity that the world in general and specifically Sri Lanka was facing due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Prudent fiscal management dictates economic decision making to be done based on sound macroeconomic fundamentals and economic realities, then present what is foreseen or projected in the future with no room for political agendas to tweak the decision-making process. Now let us look at, now yesterday I took up this issue of the European Union taking a decision in their parliament to recommend withdrawal of the GSP plus concessions. This morning, Honourable State Minister for Finance was heard to say that while the diplomatic efforts are to be pursued on one side, that they are looking at alternatives to the GSP plus conditions, that they will explore possibilities. What is the, now while you talk about looking at alternatives, now look at the reality on the ground. Now let me quote, let me show you. Exports per the 2020 annual report of the central bank to is altogether is US$9.8 billion, of which European Union accounts for 31.6% of our total exports, or US$3.1 billion. United States accounts for 24.9% of our exports. That is coming up to US$2.5 billion. And the Middle Eastern bloc, that accounts for 9.1% of our exports, US dollars, a further 900 million. India accounts for 6% of our exports, US dollars, 606 million. Now, all these countries put together, the export revenue that the country gets from this section is US$7.1 billion. Now, all this is at stake because of the way in which we are proceeding on the human rights agenda. Now, this is why the European Union is asking you to reconsider or revising the Prevention of Terrorism Act. Let me finish. Now, Prevention of Terrorism Act, you have been using it in order to muzzle dissenting opinion. You have been taking into custody political opponents. You have been using the provisions to detain people for a long time and force confessions out of them. Now, this is what happened in the Court of Appeal. In Chania Abeysekera's bail application, Court of Appeal very specifically says that the government is guilty, the CID, the CCD is guilty of fabricating evidence. to against Shani Abhaysekar. This is a very damning indictment. Damning indictment against the government by the
court. This case is proceeding in the court right now. He cannot speak about it in the chamber at this moment.
This is a judgment given already. Already the judgment has been given. These are the reasons given by the president, the Court of Appeal judge.
For granting bail.
Yes. Court of Appeal judge Bandula Karunaratna, in his order granting bail, has very specifically said that evidence have been fabricated. These are the reasons why we are on the verge of losing GSP plus concessions. Now, the government is getting its priorities mixed. Now, that is why I told you almost 7.1 billion export revenue to the Western world, including the Middle East. All that is under some danger. Now, particularly European Union almost accounts for 31.6% of our total export revenue. So we are in danger of losing all this. Now, as against this, the import bill we pay to China is a staggering 3.6 billion. Almost the same amount we are importing goods while we export. Now, we are importing from China. You see, we are paying all this money to China. You see, and this is what is the reality. But then, we depend on some friends and we antagonize other friends. Now, we can't carry on our foreign policy in this manner. We are going to totally become a pariah state if we go on in this trajectory. So there has to be a change, and there has to be a course correction by the government. This is what we are pleading, asking them to do. Now, try and reform the way in which you are governing this country. Try and ensure that minorities and religious minorities have their freedom. And poor, certain people, certain poets who have written poems have been incarcerated for more than a year. Now, there is Ahnaf Naseem. He had been held in custody for almost a year for having written a poem, and then the translation doesn't reveal anything to do with terrorism. So these are matters which have now been quoted by the European Union as reasons for them to withdraw GSP plus concessions, Mr. Presiding Member. So the government should not take this position like how
Member,
the State Minister of Finance took in the morning, saying that, let the diplomacy be on one side, but let us look for alternatives. What is alternative? Find any result. Some of the big exporters might find alternate ways, but several medium and small-scale factories will have to close. All those people will be out of jobs. And are we going to, with this pandemic staring in our face, with all these problems, are we going to heap upon ourselves this economic catastrophe? So in order to escape from this, there is no other option but to agree to reform ourselves. This is all what we're asking. So you have a course correction. At least realize your folly. You may have taken up a quite an intransigent position before the Human Rights Commission. See the damning report by the High Commissioner for Human Rights in Geneva day before yesterday.
The damning
indictment is very, very clear. Then it talks about custodial death. How many people have been dying in custody? Police is taking a suspect to identify scene of crime. And suddenly they say the fellow tried to jump out of the police jeep and he shot. There are drug offenders are taken and shot in cold blood. All this has now been recorded and are seeing this custodial death issue is a serious issue.
Time, please.
These are all human rights violations. Yeah, 7 people have died while in police custody within the last 1 year. So this is a very serious matter. So all this has to be corrected if we are to save from the anomaly of having of losing GSP plus concessions. And that will finally result in serious impact on our balance of payments debacle that we are facing. Thank you.